in case you missed it, some news and notes from around the league today. Jordan Martinuk has signed a two-year, $4 million contract extension with the Carolina Hurricanes. Elsewhere, Alex Stalock signs a three-year, $2.35 million extension with the Wild. And yesterday, we saw a sort of reverse deal between the Stars and the Penguins that saw Dallas reacquire Jamie Oleksiak back from the Penguins in exchange for that same fourth round pick that they gave away to get him in the first place. And joining us now is Jamie Oleksiak via FaceTime. Jamie, were you surprised not just by the fact that you were dealt, but that it was basically the exact same deal that sent you to Pittsburgh in the first place?
Yeah. I mean, I got that call and, you know, a little surprised when you hear it getting traded. And then, you know, they told me it was Dallas and, my jaw just kind of dropped, you know, just a whirlwind of emotions and, you know, a million thoughts going through my head. But kind of being at the rink today and seeing the guys again was cool. And, you know, it's just a comfortable feeling being back here.
All right. So you started your career there. You go to Pittsburgh. You come back. Do you have the same house? I mean, do you have the same car down there? I mean, what do you have to do to get reacclimated or you just slide back into your old life?
I mean, fortunately, like I said, I'm pretty familiar with the city, so I kind of know, you know, where most of the guys live and, you know, the different apartment buildings and stuff like that. But, yeah, I mean, I, you know, not too long ago, pretty much moved all my stuff from here up north. And, you know, now, like I said, I'm going to have to get settled down here again. But, you know, it's kind of part of the job and luckily I've done it once before. So, you know, I kind of know the steps I got to take, and it is what it is, I guess.
Jamie, just in terms of your effectiveness, your impact as an NHL defender, I mean, it's the opinion of everybody up here and even outside our network, including me, you've really grown as an NHL defender. How did the Pittsburgh experience, how did that benefit you?
Well, thanks. And, yeah, I mean, I think just being in that locker room around those guys that have obviously accomplished so much and kind of the culture they have there and seeing the work they put in day in and day out, you know, really, really helped me out. And, you know, working with some people there, Gonchar and Jock, and, you know, I feel really fortunate to, you know, have been there and play with those guys. And, you know, we got a good group here in Dallas too. So, you know, just kind of take the things I learned there and, you know, keep building on my game and keep getting better and, you know, use those experiences.
Yeah, I'm sure there was a lot to take away from a team that not only has won a couple of cups in recent years, but, you know, that also has a lot of really strong leaders off the ice as well. Yeah. I'm curious, because you're going back to a team where you already know so many guys, who was your first buddy on the Dallas Stars to try to reach out and be like, welcome back, bro? Yeah. Like, want to go to our spot? Want to hit, you know, for lunch or whatever?
Yeah, I mean, you know, a few of us went for lunch today, but to be honest, when I got the call, it was about 3 o'clock, and then you know, I got the call from Dallas and they pretty much said, you know, you got a flight at 7, so pack some things and get on the airport. So I was just in the Uber trying to answer some texts, but, you know, I got a text from all the boys, you know, a few of the Penguins guys, you know, wishing me luck. And then, you know, Chubbs reached out and, other guys here in Dallas, Klinger and, Richie. And, yeah, I mean, it's a great group of guys here and, you know, I couldn't be more excited to be back here in Dallas and, you know, hopefully make a good run.
You know, it's a special circumstance that brings you back to Dallas. Of course, they're pretty banged up on the blue line, but obviously they look at a guy where they had familiarity, and again, he's grown as an NHL defender. Has there been much discussion around between you, manager Jim Neal, and coach Montgomery? How do they see you fitting in? I have to believe, you know, the expectation is you take on a bigger workload coming back second time around.
Right. I mean, you know, I think they've pretty much just stressed, you know, the things that you've been doing in Pittsburgh, just keep working on that and keep moving forward with that. And obviously being a bigger guy and, you know, I have that reach and I have, you know, size advantage and just use that to my, you know, use that to the most. And, you know, like I said, just they've been very supportive and, you know, very encouraging. And I think I just want to build off what I kind of worked on in Pittsburgh, not trying to do too much, but keep the game simple, be effective, and be a physical presence.
You know, Jamie, on the other end of it, what's the word from a Jimmy Rutherford on the way out? What does he say to you when he moves you out and sends you back to Dallas?
You know, I mean, like I said, it's a business, and, you know, I get you know, a little bit, obviously, you know, I'm not kind of in the inner workings there, you know, it's between the GMs and whatnot, but, you know, having Schulte back and, you know, having guys step up on the back end there, you know, I think they just felt it was, you know, time to move on. And like I said, you know, I had a good talk with Jim, and, you know, I think, you know, everything's all positive from my end. And I think, you know, looking forward to being here in Dallas.
Jamie, last thing from me, the on a personal level, the two Canadians on this show are just dying to know, what's the best athlete in the family up to these days? What's Penny Oleksiak, four-time Olympic medalist, what's she up to these days?
I mean, I can't keep up with her. You know, she's all over the place. And, you know, she's even too big of a deal for me now. It's, you know, it's hard to get a reply from her, and she's all over the world and, you know,
that's
traveling
awesome.
Around. So, yeah, I mean, when we're home, we still got that brother-sister dynamic, and, you know, I try and keep her level-headed as much as possible. But
doing your part as her brother, right?
Yeah, exactly. That's my job, right?
Exactly.
That's great.
Before we let you go, what is the over-under on the amount of times you've been asked about Penny Oleksiak's career?
Oh, all the time. I mean, like, to be honest, like, I'll be back in Toronto, I've gone to a couple stores, and you know, they say, "Hey, you're Penny's brother." You know what I mean? That's what I'm known as. I feel like more than being a hockey player, so it's interesting, you know.
Well, you know what? You're earlier in your career, so you got lots of time for people to start approaching her as your sister and to kind of turn the tables there a little bit. Listen, have a blast in Dallas. Thank you for joining us on the show. We appreciate it. We know that you're busy. Enjoy the rest of your day.
All right, thanks a lot, guys. Take care.